after I graduated from the Department of Epidemiology, I accepted a postdoctoral fellowship with the Department of Population, Family, and Reproductive Health. I was conducting research with that fellowship, mostly implementation science-based research, and then became faculty after my postdoc. I was faculty for a few years and then went to the health department, became the director of social epidemiology and evaluation. That led to my current position, which is the public sector initiatives lead with the Bloomberg American Health Initiative. I provide technical support, generally around the opioid crisis, to a number of city and state agencies across the US who are responding to the opioid crisis. The other part of my position involves research and teaching, as well as mentoring students. I found my first position after graduate school through word of mouth. And I would say that's my biggest piece of advice in terms of finding a position after you graduate is networking. So while you're at the school, definitely try to get involved as much as you can in different research projects without overwhelming yourself, so that you can get as much exposure as possible to different skills, but also the individuals who may be hiring you later will know more about you, and it'll make it easier when you graduate to find a position. Hopkins provided me with a lot of tools for my tool belt, particularly the technical aspects of what I do. So translating research, understanding research really, and the implications of the research, understanding the broader scope of the context of the research, I think I came very well prepared to the public sector to provide. Some of the things that were a little more challenging was how to translate that research for a more lay audience. We're trained very well at the university how to talk to other academics. What's more challenging is how to know all of the intricate details of the research, but kind of throw that away and find the kernel of the research that the public sector really needs to know based on what their current activities and what their needs are. And so providing things like graphics and, you know, one-pagers, briefs, and doing that in a way that doesn't have a bunch of technical jargon is something that I had to learn a little more on the fly. Some of the experiences that I would recommend while you're at the university is to do community-based participatory research. What that will allow you to do is understand some of the challenges that our public agencies are experiencing, as well as learn about how to communicate well. Some of the other opportunities at the university include the phase internship through Source, where you're really getting the experience of working in the community in a non-academic setting. I also recommend a lot of the service learning courses that the faculty teach here, and those are growing in numbers. Again, what that will help you do is to apply your technical expertise in a more general setting. For epidemiologists who are looking for a public sector position, I think what you will find is that the public sector generally pays a little less. It's on the lower end of the range for epidemiologists. Some of the benefits that you'll get in the public sector setting are pensions if you decide to stick with it long term, and the experience that you'll get, the real practical, practice-based experience that you'll get in the public sector is, from my perspective, definitely worth the pay cut. What I would say is working with a public sector partner, particularly at the local level, is really valuable experience because you have such an opportunity for impacting programs and policies compared to something like the CDC or FDA, where there's a lot of bureaucracy. That's not to say it doesn't exist at the local level, but you have an opportunity to really encounter those who have direct contact with individuals that we are hoping to serve. So I would say that generally those positions are considered less prestigious, but the bang for your buck in working at a city or state public health agency is great, because you'll have the kinds of knowledge that will help create greater impact in the long run.